Action.
Good day, this MJ. Right now, we are here to interview one of the senatorial aspirant this coming May 2022 election, no other than Engineer Dr. Bertito Del Mundo Hashimoto. Good day, Doc.
Good day sa ating lahat. It's my pleasure and privilege to present myself. It's an honor to serve my motherland.
Doc Bert, Engineer Bert, being a senatorial independent candidate this coming 2022 election, what will be your platform of government?
Well, senatorial is legislation, di ba? Maraming mali, ituwid natin ang mali. Maraming kulang, dagdagan natin. What I wish is, Philippines, as you said, na sa pandemic situation po tayo, nag-iirap ang kampanya natin. So, hindi alam ng mga nakaupo ngayon kung saan sila kukuha ng pondo, saan sila kukuha ng pangtapa sa problema nangyari, sila nag-away. Well, we need a new face. I am a new face. So, I have knowledge to bring wealth to the country. So, ako po kay, ang focus ko is legislative. May pasa sa Senate ang natural resources natin para ma-extract. Without legislation, walang mangyari. Ngayon natin sa Pilipinas, nalagay lahat sa legislation. Ultimong tulay sa barangay, ultimong tulay, kailangan may batas. Ultimong pag-extract, kailangan may batas. Wala pang naging batas ang national government top level position. Yung extraction ng oil and gas, we are the richest nation in the whole world about natural gas. Yun po ang Benham Rice, yung tinutukoy ko. There is a 13 million hectares of Benham Rice. If we extract that liquefied natural gas, it will bring 800 billion in our government treasury. So, pag mayroong 800 billion, malakas po ang pagiging anong bansa natin. Yung economy natin, magbo-boom. So, marami tayong engineer, mga professional na sa ibang bansa. So, kahit bumuwi na po kayo, hindi na po kayo maghirap kasi what we need to do is unite for this, the progress of this country. The Philippines needed you. The country you are serving there, hindi po abang buhay na sa ibang bansa kayo. Kailangan po kayo ng ating bayan. Tulungan po natin. Sa mga panahon namin, panunungkulan, mga aking presidente at mga kapwa senador, magkaisa po tayo. Stop sending servant in Poryanan. By the near future, the Poryan people, the white, the red, the yellow, the black, or whoever they are, come to the Philippines. You are our servant. You become our mates, laborers. Not slave. We are not. Wala kaming ugaling magalipin.
Slavery culture.
Because even the 50 years, 100 years, 500 years, we are slave. But forget that slaving mindset. We are the progress. We are the Philippine hospitality is the number one hospitality in the whole world.
Doc, regarding naman po, you said the platform of government, and as I remember, before our mga scientists here in the country, you're the first to make the feasibility studies regarding Benham Rice, right?
Yes, I did it. I don't know what happened. God gave me a wisdom. So this wisdom is implemented to the country. I thought it's not a joke. I am become a butterfly. Myself, I know myself. But myself, I thought I am common. But the knowledge given to me by the Almighty is like a wisdom. Solomon, David, Joseph, yes. We need a leader. The up is up. The lower position are in mind will become preparation for the country, the next generation. What happening now is they are all political dynasty maneuver. The next generation is doesn't thinking because they only thought they are living for 5 to 10 years preparation. It's not enough. My legislation will be the next generation. If you not do the right thing now, what happened to the next generation? We'll become poor. We'll become slave again. Stop. No, we have, what we have to do is focus on the next generation. This country is rich in natural resources. This country is educated. There are a lot of engineers, doctors, nurses. We have a lot. But the problem is, our mindset is servant. Now, we will transfer the mindset from servant to masters, to businessman. If we extract the Vietnam rice, they will creating 100 million jobs, 100,000 jobs, a million jobs. I think I need 2,500 engineers, 5 million laborers. It's a big numbers. No, it creating the economic boom in not only in urbanized city. We need a rural development. Okay?
Synchronizing both rural and urban areas?
Yes. The urbanized city is so crowded. The rural area is empty. The land is so wide and big.
There's a lot of idle land all over the country, yes. Specifically in Mindanao.
We are agricultural country, agricultural. Our fishery, there is a fishery. We need to provide feeds, foods to our countrymen. Now, the wide is, the farm land is so wide, but nobody touch it. That's why we need to create another jobs, another seeds, another progressive seedling to how we'll prepare the foods on the table. How we'll prepare the peace on the table. We are surrounding by water. Why you are importing galonggong? Why importing peace? That is stupid. We are so many mountains empty and they can feed a million of cattle. Why we are importing meat? That is so stupid.
Because we are in the archipelagic nation.
Yeah, this is tropical country. They can live 24 hours. The cow, the goat, the sheep, they can eat freely 24 hours a day in their backyard, in the land, in the farm was pasture land.
Back on the upcoming election on national and local election of 2022, do you have a database or full support of the leader? Because as independent, you don't have the political party.
Well, as I said, I am praising God to give me chances. This is a call. Not all call to become a chosen. But I push myself. This is my dream. I put educated myself. I just put also, pull my pocket. So, you know, in this country, money talks. And even you are very poor of knowledge, but if you have money, you are win. So I'm working to my money. I think will be right before direction. How much? I don't know how much, but no problem. It's a billion.
But not only that, but also on the educational. You prepared yourself that you have a different post degree.
Well, if you stand as a leader, you may educated first because you cannot stand in the front of the people in the front. Of our constituent, if you don't know how to talk, if you don't know how to serve them. Myself is serving people, not the people serve me. I will dedicate myself to the country until my last breath.
Lastly, your message to the Filipino people.
Well, my dear countrymen, women, and men and women, let's unite. Sa pagkakaisa, nandun po ang pag-asa, sa pagkakaisa, pagtulong-tulungan, nandun po ang magandang kinabukasan. Educated po yung sarili nyo sa tama, hindi mapuputo sa mali. Tapos na po ang nakaraang banggaan ng mga politiko. Yung mga luma, palitan na. Yung mga bagong kagaya namin, may talino, may saka sa loob, sa magandang kinabukasan. Kami po ay nakikusap sa inyo. Tulungan nyo kami, tutulungan namin kayo. Maraming salamat po at magandang araw sa ating lahat.
You've just witnessed our interview, not just a new face, but a prepared to be a legislator this coming 2022, no other than senatorial candidate, Dr. Engineer Bertito del Mundo Hashimoto. This is MG Albina Balaguer of DCMG Online, Makabuluhang Journalismo, your happiness channel.